state purification of colloid solutions. How we can purify? Purification of colloid solution and why it is necessary. Colloid solution when prepared generally contain excessive amount of electrolytes, some other soluble impurities, etc. Okay. While the presence of traces of electrolyte is essential for the stability of the colloid solution, but larger quantities it coagulates it. It is therefore necessary to reduce the concentration of these soluble impurities to a requisite minimum. So the process used for the reducing the amount of impurities to a requisite minimum is known as purification of colloid solution. So purification of colloid solution is carried out by the following methods. How we can purify it? This method is dialysis. And you already know, for human beings, dialysis is very important. Our in kidney, it is automatic dialysis system. But if someone has the kidney failure problem, then artificially dialysis is very important for them. So it is a process of removing a dissolved substance from a colloidal solution by means of diffusion through a suitable membrane. So you already know some of publics have the kidney problem, and for them dialysis is very important because blood contains different type of impurities which is toxic for them. So the dialysis is necessary. What is diffusion? You already know, from the higher concentration to lower concentration when molecules is dispersed. Okay, is known as diffusion. And what is membrane? It may be made up of an animal membrane, that is like bladder or parchment paper or silicone sheet, etc. And it is a selective barrier which allows the movement of ions of small molecules and retain colloidal particles. Okay. For dialysis, it is very important because it can allow the movement of ions or small molecules, and it contains main colloidal particles. So impurity may be removed by this membrane. The apparatus used for the dialysis is called dialyzer. So working principle of dialysis as follows. So you see that there is inlet, this is outlet, this is outlet, this is inlet. Okay, so it is outlet, it is inlet. Then there is a membrane, this is the colloidal system, there are some impurities. So it may be the blood bag, no problem. A bag of suitable membrane contains the colloidal solution is suspended in a vessel. Salt particles, okay, crystalloids, so water in, water out. The water is continuously flowing, when the molecules and ions diffuse through the membrane into the outer water and purified colloid solution is left behind the bag. So in this way, it will be removed. So purification of colloid solution by electrodialysis. So that was the normal dialysis, but now we can use electrodialysis. That's mean by electricity, we can attract the positive or negative part of the colloids. That's mean from the for the impurities only. So ordinarily the process of dialysis is quite slow, but for a kidney patient, if the slow process is occurred, it is whole day it will spend, then it will not working. Okay, because slow process is not expected. For the kidney failure man, once a week if we do dialysis, it is enough. But by ordinary dialysis, it will take whole day. Then every day it should be dialysis. So it is not possible for any human beings. For this reason, electrodialysis process is used for faster the process. So it can be made faster by applying an electric field. If the dissolved substance in the impure colloidal solution is only an electrolyte, the process is then named electrolysis. Working principle of electrodialysis as follows. It is like this. These colloidal particles are already charged particle. Okay, dialysis membrane. The same process is here, but there is a impurities, and we will use the electrodialysis. So we will use current. Okay, the bags suitable membrane contains the colloidal solution is suspended in a vessel, and there will be a cathode anode. There will be cathode. This is cathode anode. Okay, and there is a battery, or it may be current switch. Okay, then this negative attract this positive part, and positive attract this negative part, and only the impurities will come out, but main colloidal particles remains in the back. Okay, the process of removing a dissolved substances from a colloidal solution by means of diffusion is called, what is this? Dialysis. Okay, the process of dialysis can be made faster by applying this electric field. So purification of colloidal solution, this is two. Purification of colloidal solution by ultrafiltration. It is a process of separating the colloidal particles from the solvent and soluble solutes present in the colloidal solution by specially prepared filters, which is permeable to all substances except the colloidal particles. So all particles is permeable by this filter paper, but colloidal particles is not. So what is the need for the preparing the special filter paper? So this is the ordinary filter papers. Through the ordinary filter papers, colloidal particle may remove. Okay, so this is passed through the ordinary particle or ordinary filter paper. Okay, all colloidal particles pass through the ordinary filter paper, but when you will use the special filter paper, then what happen? So the pores of the filter paper can be reduced in size by impregnating with the colloidal solution. The usual colloidal is a 4% solution of the nitrocellulose, the mixture of alcohol and ethanol. Now, the ultra filter paper may be prepared by the following steps: soaking the filter paper in the colloidal solution, hardening the soaked filter paper with formaldehyde solution, finally drying it. Then it will be special filter paper, ultra filter paper. Then, if we use the ultra filter paper, then from the colloidal particles, it will remove the impurity. Okay. If we apply pressure, then colloid particles remains here, but impurity removes from the filter paper. So ultra filtration is carried by ordinary specially prepared filter paper, ordinary specially filter paper. Properties of colloidal solution: various properties exhibited by the colloidal solution are described here. In chemistry, colloidal properties are properties of solution that depends upon the ratio of the number of solute particles and the number of solvent molecules in the solution, and not on the types of chemical species present. So colligative properties, we already discussed about the colligative properties in the solution chapter, which is the property of a solution which depends on the solute particles only. So osmotic pressure is also the colligative properties of a solution. So it is the, what is the osmotic pressure? It is the external pressure applied to the solution in order to stop the osmosis of the solvent into the solution system. So what was the osmosis and reverse osmosis? The flow of the solvent through a semi-permeable membrane from a dilute solution to the concentrated solution. It is known as osmosis. There is also a reverse osmosis occur. A membrane which is permeable to solvent and not to solute. Semi-permeable membrane means the membrane which is permeable to solvent but not solute. Colloidal properties also, there was a four colligative properties. One was the osmotic pressure, another was the lowering of the vapor pressure, dispersion, depression of freezing point, and elevation of boiling point. Okay, this four was the colligative property we already studied on solution chapter. Okay, colloidal particles peak aggregates compared to the particles in true solution, you already know. Okay, this true solution the particle size is really small, and for colloidal particles, it is bigger size than true solution, and the size of the colloidal particles is 10 to the minus 5 centimeter, 10 to the minus 7 centimeter. So as you know, for a given number of solvent molecules, colligative properties are directly proportional to the number of solute particles, because we already discussed about the colligative property, the property of a solution which can only depends on the number of solute particles. So we can conclude that the number of particles in the colloidal solution is less than the number of particles in the true solution. Hence, the value of the colligative properties is of small order to compared to the value of the true solution at the same concentration, because size of the colloidal particle is higher than the true solution. Before discussing the second property of the colloidal solution, let me ask one question. What is this? If we see the chemical projection, have you gone to a cinema hall? Or in your room also, there is a gulguli jeta ke bola hai, arthat jekhane light dhukte pare, So it is shows Tyndall effect. Have you noticed scatter light beam while projecting a movie on a screen? Or when light passes through a hole, we can see some particles, or we can see the scattering of light, okay, which is known as actually Tyndall effect. Should you want to know how it happens? This happens due to the Tyndall effect. Okay. So anyone can ask you the Tyndall effect. The Tyndall effect is due to the fact that colliding particles scatter light in all directions in space. Let us see what is happening here. It is true solution. It may be colloidal solution. It is colloidal solution, homogeneous solution placed in darkness. Okay. Then light source appears clear in the direction of the light beam if it is true solution. Okay. And now if it is colloidal solution, then what happened? For colloidal solution, the light source appeared transmitted in the direction of light beam. Okay. That's mean scatter of light will occur. So what is the Tyndall effect? Already know. If it is colloidal solution, if it is light source, then we can see different color. So scattering of light beam is due to the fact that solid particles absorb light energy and then emit in all direction in the space. For this reason, there are so many colors may be seen. Michael Faraday. This effect was first observed by Faraday. Tyndall. Condition for Tyndall effect. Tyndall effect is observed only when the following two conditions are satisfied. If it is colloidal solution, okay, that's mean diameter of dispersed particle is not much smaller than the wavelength of the light used, and the refraction index, the dispersed phase and the dispersion medium differ directly in the magnitude, and refractive index. What is the refractive index in physics? You already studied it. It is the ratio of the velocity of light in the vacuum to its velocity in the specified medium. That's mean velocity of light in any medium divided by velocity of light in vacuum. Tyndall effect is used to distinguish between a colloidal solution and true solution. At your knowledge, is a Donald Zygmondy. He already said about the colloidal solution, zigzag way or sigmoidal way. Or you can say it is Brownian movement. He experimented the colloidal solution, which was placed in a glass vessel. Individual colloidal particles appear as a bright stars against dark background. An ultramicroscope did not provide any information about the size of or shape of the colloidal particles, but only helped to observe the light scatter by them. Color properties depends upon number of particles, number of solvent molecules, type of chemical species, or A and B. Which one? Number of solute particles and number of solvent molecules. Colligative properties among these: osmotic pressure, lowering of vapor pressure, depletion of freezing. That's not all of this. Yes. Properties of colloidal solution. Color. The color of the colloidal solution depends on the wavelength of the light scattered by the dispersed particles. If it is like yes, it may be virgin, okay, because there are so many wavelength, or it contains virgin contains different wavelength of the lights, and it will be different color. So what is the wavelength of the light? You know already the distance between two phase. So waves have different wavelengths. You already know. This is amplitude. This is also amplitude. So distance between two amplitude is known as wavelength. Okay. Wavelength is the distance between two successive crest or troughs or two amplitude. Different colors of light have different wavelengths. Okay. If the wavelength between 380 to 450 nanometer, then it will be, it appears as violet. If it is 450 to 495 nanometer, it appears as blue. Okay, in this way, it will be orange. It will be red. So the color of the colloidal solution depends on the wavelength of light scattered by the dispersed particle. The wavelength of light depends on the size and shape of the particles. And gold salt also contains different color. Finest gold salt is red because its size, when its size increases, then it will be golden. Okay. So colloidal particle shape, spherical particles scatter red light, Ritz like particle is blue light. Okay, in this way, shorter wavelength of light is scattered by larger particles and vice versa, and the color of the colloidal particles, colloidal solution changes with the manner in which observer receives the light. For example, a mixture of milk and water appears blue when viewed by the reflected light and the red when viewed by the transmitted light. In this way, light may, color may be changed. Wavelength of light depends on size, the particle, shape of the particle, okay, so A and B. Brownian movement, that means zigzag way, and movement of colloidal particle in zigzag way, which is known as Brownian movement, a sigmoidal movement. When colloidal solution are viewed under a powerful ultramicroscope, then according to Robert Brown, this motion first observed by the British botanist Robert Brown and is known as Brownian movement. This motion is independent of the nature of the colloids, but it depends on the size of the particles and viscosity of the solution. If viscosity is high, then movement will be low. Okay. So what is the viscosity? Viscosity is the resistance to the free flow of movement. That's mean the movement will be slow down if it is viscous medium. The Brownian movement is due to the unbalanced bombardment between the colloidal particles and the molecules of the dispersion phase. That's mean bombardment. One molecule collide with each other and there is always movement. That is bombardment between colloidal particles. For this reason, they can move anywhere in any direction. Do you know why colloidal size particles do not settle down under gravity? Because there are Brownian movement or there are bombardment. So, what do What happened? The Brownian movement has a stirring effect which does not permit the particles to settle, and thus it is responsible for the stability of the soil. If it is settled down, then the colloidal system will be seized and they will be coagulate or settle down. And the same charge is there for the same charge. They repel to each other. For this reason, the Brownian movement also occur. Colloidal particles always carry an electric charge. The nature of this charge is the same on all the particles in the given colloidal solution and may be either positive or negative. So negative, negative, repel to each other, positive, positive, repel to each other. So colloidal particles, most of the colloidal particles are same charge. Okay, for this reason, they repel to each other and they remain in the system. So they are not settled down. It may be hydrated metallic oxide salt also. There are so many metal salts, copper, silver, gold, salt, etc. Sulfide salt, arsenic sulfide, indium sulfide, cadmium sulfide, etc. There are so many salt. So Brownian movement is due to bombardment of the particles, yes. Movement of particles in straight line. At a subsequent scattering of light. No. None of this, no. Okay. Bombardment of particles. Hemoglobin is a positively, negatively, or neutral, or that is positive charged. And thank you. Sajid, এটার যে নোটস গুলো পাঠিয়েছিলাম সেগুলো পড়েছো? What is to that, it is end. Okay.
Okay, sir.
Okay, sir.